Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, All Things Food, with your favorite mother chef, Chef Porche. Today we're going to be starting the first of 12 days inspired by the 12 days of Christmas. Our first recipe is going to be inspired by the partridge in a pear tree. Basically, it's going to be a pear recipe where we bake it off with granola, brown sugar, honey and cinnamon, and you usually serve it with a side of frozen yogurt or frozen ice cream. So we're going to start by preheating the oven to 375, which I've already done, and then the next step would be to take your pears. We're going to do four. You do however many you choose for however many you want, which four is going to make about eight servings because you're going to cut them in half. So we're going to do four. And what you're going to do is you're going to cut them in half, each one. Okay, and then you're going to take a spoon or a melon baller, an ice cream scoop, whatever your utensil of choice is, and you're going to scoop out the middle, basically getting the seeds out and creating a cusp to put your filling in. So I'm just going to take a spoon and you're just going to kind of dig in there and turn and create a circle. And you're just going to take that and put that in a pan. You also, if you're worried about it wobbling, you could always take, let me move these out the way, sorry. You could always take the bottom of it and just cut like a little bit of it off so that it creates a flat bottom for you, and then boom, no movement. It's perfectly fine. So we're just gonna do that with all of these. I basically wanted to do the 12 days of Christmas, and so I basically dug through recipes, trying to think of recipes that's inspired by the 12 days of Christmas. So this next 12 days, there's going to be different types. It's going to be, make sure we get the sticker off. Of course, we pre-washed them before and everything, but make sure you wash your fruits, your vegetables, whatever you're cooking before, you know. Cleanliness is next to godliness. So you're just going to cut that out. And so these next 12 days, I will be doing just different recipes inspired by the 12 days of Christmas. Today is like considered like a dessert, I guess you would consider. And there will also be cocktails, there will be full entree dishes, so it won't be a repetitive thing where it's just all dessert. It's different ones that you can do for your family. You can have the kids help with you. This is one of those recipes that's really fun to do, because you can have the kids, you know, hollow out the pears and help make the filling. And then of course they'll love to eat it once it's done. Who doesn't love some pears? Rick Ross lost all his weight because of pears. Shout out to pears. Okay, so I think this is the last one. Just gonna put those in there. And you don't need parchment or you don't need parchment. You don't need to butter the pan, any of that, because we're leaving the skin on the pears. You don't need it. Anything to basically keep it from sticking. The skin is going to help with that. Now, if you are to cut the bottoms off and you are scared or worried about it sticking because of the sugars that we're going to be put on here, you could use parchment in a pan, or you can lightly oil it. You don't want to over oil it and have the bottom of the pears kind of fry off. So you're going to get a bowl and you're going to take either homemade granola or store-bought granola. A lot of these recipes I'm going to do are going to be easy recipes for the 12 days of Christmas. So I just went ahead and did store-bought. Now, I can make homemade granola. I can make homemade a lot of things. But today we're just going to do a little store-bought. Make it easy. Just going to put about... this is about 11 ounces. I'm going to put about 5 in there. And then we're going to take about... okay, 4 tablespoons of brown sugar. Okay. And then about, where'd the spoon go? Two tablespoons of cinnamon. Okay. Just take that and just kind of mix them up together. You don't need butter. You don't need anything added to it. Just the brown sugar, the cinnamon, and the granola. The pears, flesh, and the honey that we're going to add to this is going to help with the moisture. So you don't need any extra. So you're just going to basically take some of that granola, cinnamon, brown sugar mixture, and just lay it right on the inside of each pear. Make sure, a nice amount, don't be stingy. Yeah. Make sure you want to get a nice helping. And if you get some chunks, like if you get some chunks like this, it's okay. It's okay.
Try a piece.
Yeah, you can try a piece.
That's good.
Okay. You just add that right on in there. That voice you hear off to the side is my oldest son. He's one of my taste testers. Go follow him. Flicks by JB. He's doing something great over there. He has other pages too, but. Okay. Let's just go ahead. And if you got a little bit left in there, just go ahead and just divvy it off. There you go. And now you're going to take the honey. And I'm using raw honey, but it doesn't have to be raw honey. It could be the fake honey, I guess. but I'm using raw honey. And you just literally just drizzle it right over. Over each pear. And the thing about this dessert is it's quite healthy. It's healthy. Aside from the brown sugar, everything is natural. So you can kind of trick the kids into thinking they're, cheating. But, yeah. So it's just going to look like this. I don't know, you can't see me over there, but, yeah. And you just pop it into the oven. You got the oven on 375. Just gonna pop it into the oven. It's gonna be in the oven about 20 25 minutes, and then pull it out and serve. So we're gonna let these bake off and then we'll be right back. Okay, so it's been 25 minutes. We've let the pears bake, so we're gonna check them and see if they're ready to come out and go from there. Okay, so what you're looking for is, let me close this back. So you're just going to check for a tenderness of it. The glaze of the honey and the granola, everything incorporated together. And then you're gonna let it sit and cool for a little bit. If you like really hot fruit, you can dig into it now. You can place it on a plate with some frozen yogurt or frozen ice cream and dig right into it. But otherwise, I would just let it cool down for a little bit and then you can dig right into it. So we're gonna let it cool for about 5 minutes. 5 minutes should be enough time for it to cool down enough for it to be edible. So we're just gonna let it cool down and then we'll give it a taste. Okay, so the pears have cooled down, so it's time to taste, which is everybody's favorite part. So I'm gonna call in my little guinea pigs, my taste testers, kids. Oh, she was ready. She was ready. Okay. So, all right. So, just gonna give each one of them one to taste.
Yeah, bro, you want your breath? You got it, but
yes. There you go.
Thank you.
And be careful because they might be just still a little warm.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
Do I just like cut down a minute? I'm number 8.
And you cut wherever you want to. If you want to go straight for the middle, wait, if you want to go from the side, just.
Wait, wait,
some
wait.
Of the cinnamon.
That's all I try at the same time.
Okay.
Why are you finna get
put mine on Trish's plate.
Okay. Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's all right.
All right.
You got me a spoon.
I'm trying to get some of like all of it on it.
And I'm just gonna taste one out the pan. I can do that. Everyone want to taste it? What's the other taste tester want to say? All right, you can dig in.
That's
right. Yep.
Ooh,
it's hot.
Mmm. Mm.
It's hot. It's not
to me.
That's good though.
I like it.
That's good. You can actually. Sorry, I got food in my mouth. And you can actually, if you let them cool enough, where you don't have to use a spoon, you can just take the whole thing and just bite into it. But again, I would suggest you can eat it by itself, or you could serve it with frozen yogurt or frozen ice cream. Either way, it's good.
Yes.
So that's gonna be it for the first day of Christmas. With our version of Partridge in a Pear Tree. like, comment, and subscribe. Chef kisses and hugs. We're out.
walking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.